Los Angeles is having the biggest fire in history. More than 1,000 firefighters battling the largest wildfire in Los Angeles history contended with erratic winds on Sunday, but more moderate temperatures could help contain a blaze that has forced hundreds to evacuate their homes, officials said. The 5,900-acre La Tuna Fire, named after the canyon on near the northern edge of Los Angeles, where it erupted on Friday, has destroyed three homes. Authorities have evacuated more than 700 homes in the Los Angeles neighborhood and in nearby Burbank and Glendale. The blaze in thick brush that has not burned in decades was slowly creeping down rugged hillsides toward houses and was only 10% contained by Sunday. The Los Angeles Fire Chief Ralph Terrazas said at a news conference Sunday, "There's a lot of fuel out there left to burn. This is just horrendous." Glendale. Here's Lakeview Terrace. There's also a floods, flash flood watch. Southwest California, including recent burn areas. Hopefully that'll put them out. The worst fire in Los Angeles history. Everything is breaking records. So this brush fire, they say it has a lot of fuel to burn. That means there's a lot of brush left. In Idaho, swarms of earthquakes since September 2nd. September 3rd, look at all of these. And they're still going off. 3.3, 3.2, 2.7. Let's take a closer look. Oh my God! This whole area! From Soda Springs, Idaho, up to Conda, Idaho. There were two earthquakes in Salt Lake City. And here's Irma, which has a spaghetti string going all the way up to right where I live. This hits us again. It will be another Sandy. This is going west, northwest. I know there are other maps, but everybody's showing the other map, so I'm showing this map. I got the buoys up, and 1.6 millimeters of water is 9 miles. 9 miles. 1 millimeter, but 9 miles. Wow. So, see what this buoy is? 0.7 is 4 miles. Not available. So, this is going to be a big one. 2.3 millimeters is 1 mile high. So, the lighter the color, the higher the wave. Not available. Okay. This is the wildfire detection, the yellow. This string moved around a little bit. It's going to go up past Washington, Trenton, New York, and here's where I live in a little island stuck in here. So it looks like it might just sweep by us. We'll get heavy rains. Then it's gonna move out, and then it looks like it's coming back. And if it comes back, so we'll see what happens. This weekend it's gonna be in the 80s, which it's been in the 60s so far. So, summer is winter and winter is summer. Something out that I wanted to say. See how far in this is going inland into the Carolinas and all up here? This is moving fast, okay? People shouldn't wait for the authorities on TV to tell them to start evacuating. Go to a relative's house or just start moving before it hits, especially the shoreline. Look at how far inland this is going. All these people, get out, start packing all your stuff that you want, going inland, all the way inland, and start doing it now. Don't let them tell you, oh, stay put. You know, don't believe anything they tell you on TV. Oh, it's going to go this way. They don't know which way it's going to go. Look at this string, where it's going to go. I don't know. I might have to get the hell out myself. And then this whole island here, my son lives over here. If it's going to be rain, okay. If it's going to be rain and wind, that's not good. We got a cold front coming down that might push it off. They don't want to be alarmist, and I don't blame them in a way. But keep track yourself and start putting your stuff in suitcases now, especially in the Carolinas. Don't count on anybody saving you because they're overwhelmed with Houston. That's all I want to say. Just get ready.